two questions. One from Alvin. Alvin L. Question is, do you believe in training with improvised weapons?
Oh, okay.
And second question coming from Tenacious for Life. What motivates you to train aside from just self-defense?
Okay, let's answer one at a time. You want to come in and help me with the first one with improvised weapons? Okay. So say if you attack me, right? And anyone you like will tell me what you're going to do. You come in. There's improvised weapon, right? So it's just a flashlight. I always have a flashlight with me at nighttime. So that's an example of improvised weapon, right? So I just came in, I flashed it at you, and you flinched there. Right? From here, I went down like this. This is straight from your forearm, right? This kind of movement. And from here, I went down and went for the head. And this is metal, so if the head's going to hurt, you probably see it better on this side. If I was here and he came down, from here you can do a bunch of stuff, right? So from here, if I want to take you down, I can go here, and down he goes, right? So slowly, if I push you in the back, nothing happens. But if I make a circle out of it, he turns, right? That's straight from the forms. So you can use these movements. But for me, improvised weapon is kind of like, improvised weapons kind of, sometimes it gets carried away, right? Like the other day, I saw an ad for a tactical hat and a tactical ring. Next thing they're gonna have like, I don't know, tactical napkins or something. Instead of relying on gadgets and tactical improvised weapons, personally, I think it's better to train with classical stuff, like a spear, like a sword, like an axe, like a whip, like a stick, like a knife, like a broadsword. And people say that's not practical because you can't carry that around, but they're missing the point. When you train with different classical weapons, you're actually educating your body to get used to different length, width, weight. So naturally, after you train with so many different objects and masks, any object you pick up, whether it's a chair or umbrella or a flashlight, whatever, you can naturally use it because you're used to different masks, length, and width, right? So when you train a classical weapon, you're actually educating your nervous system to adapt. And adaptability is more important. And adaptability, to me, is more reliable than relying on the latest toys or latest gadgets, tactical gadgets. So second question?
So second question was, what motivates you to keep training aside from self-defense?
My stuff is based on self-defense, but it's not really my motivation because I live in a really big country. And I try to apply traditional martial art concepts, like treating everyone with respect. So my chances of getting a fight are very low, so I don't really train for self-defense. That's not what motivates me, you know? What motivates me is I love martial arts, and I don't know why, I just love it. And I think if you don't love something, you need a lot of reasons to train, like reasons marketed to you, train to be confident, train to lose weight, train to kick ass, whatever. But the minute you love something, you don't need marketing reasons. When you love something, you don't have a reason. You can't put your finger on it. So you don't need a reason. If you have a reason, usually after a while, you lose motivation, right? I don't know if I answered the question, but that's my opinion. Okay. Let's go get something to eat.